My name is Muhammad Iqbal Chaudhry. I was born in Karachi. I was raised in a family of five children. So I started my education at the age of about 4 or 3 and a half. My mother was deeply religious. She used to explain that in the holy book, there are so many verses of universe and creation of humanity and creation of universe, and that our religion teaches to be more proactively looking into the truth. So we were pondering about different phenomena. We used to see galaxies, we used to look into different animals. You know, that was an extremely important factor in my intellectual development. And then in my secondary school, I have had the opportunity of benefiting from some very good teachers. So our laboratories for chemistry and physics and biology were as good as anywhere else in the world. Then I moved to university, and university was again, I have access to some very good teachers. Initially I got admission in University of Arizona, but then I decided to remain in Pakistan because I met Professor Atta Rahman, who was my mentor. Professor Atta has gave me sense of direction. He gave me the depth of thinking. And I traveled to Pennsylvania State University, which is a very high quality institution. I completed my PhD and then got the opportunity of my postdoc in Cornell University. And I work in frontiers of science and technology. So I was working on the structural chemistry using all the modern tools of organic chemistry, such as NMR spectroscopy, X-ray diffraction, mass spectrometry. The project is all about using nature's diversity, and in nature's diversity, there are lots of chemical diversity. So everything natural you pick, and you would identify lots of fascinating molecules. These molecules are capable of locking disease mechanism. And what we have done in last 3 decades is to actually use profound knowledge of chemistry and biological sciences to identify molecules which are present in nature as drug-like molecules. Some of them were active as antibacterial, some of them are active as antiviral, some of them are active against the epilepsy, some of them are active against cancer. And project has been extremely successful because since last 3 decades, we have been looking into various kinds of chemicals from different sources, from marine organisms, from medicinal plants, from fungi and bacteria, and isolated this fascinating array of complex structure. I used to read a lot. I used to read about medieval Muslim scientists who laid the foundation of modern science as it is today. And I used to read about Al-Biruni, Al-Khwarizmi, about Ibn Rushd and other. From 7th century to 12th century, Muslim world led the entire humanity in terms of science and technology. And there were many scientists from West Asia who contributed in the development of science and technology. Is it time for us to go back, understand the fundamentals of what is required to be done? And this is the reason why initiatives such as Mustafa's Science and Technology Prize has a pivotal role in encouraging people to go back to the science and technology and start contributing towards the betterment of humanity by innovation and by research.